Okay, you don't start out being good. You've got to go through this progression of dying a lot, understanding what's happening. In fact, that's what my next video is going to be. I'm going to look at a replay, and I'm going to show you how you can self-analyze to help you get better in whatever you do. It doesn't matter if it's Team Fortress 2 or if it's in things in life. Having that self-reflection, having that ability to criticize yourself is definitely a thing you need to have. G'day all, Mr. Paladin here today, and I'm looking at a community game where I was playing a Saharan spy. So I was taking a Latranje with a Your Eternal Reward, and I was wearing the Fez, and I'm using a Dead Ringer. Well, there's a spy here. So a lot of strange things happened in this life, and I just, like I said in a previous video, I like to reflect when stuff like this happens, just so I can learn from it and see what went right, what went wrong, as things did in this game. I don't know if a spy got away here, but it was quite clear from the replay that the spy was dead. Well, see the error from that sniper. Oh man, replays. I backstabbed the error. So here, I'm on the sniper disguise. Trying to sneak around, getting behind that demo man. He hasn't noticed. I see a spy trying to get up the rock. He was disguised as a heavy, so I'm trying to keep my eye out for him, and I pick him up. That pyro's gonna turn around at any moment. And I'm disguised as a spy, so I'm acting spy-like. I thought I could jump down and get behind that soldier. But once I realized that I didn't quite get him, I had to get away from that. I don't think I've got a disguise.
After you.
Pretty sure I don't have my disguise. Looking for any disguise. Can I get the fire? No, he gets me good. And using these rocks as cover. Engineer did not see it. What's backing up? There we go, a scout backed up. Now for the scout disguise, so I'm jumping around like a scout. That sniper obviously saw it. I think I was getting a heal from our medic. Oh, I apologize to this demo man. I took his health pack. I looked at him and I saw that he was low health as well, but he gives the taunt as an okay. We all know it was okay. Jump over that error. Just kind of hanging out for the enemy. They haven't come over the hill. See if I can get behind anything. Get behind this heavy. See if I can bait that medic behind me to come on forward. And we do get him to come forward. He does follow me in. Well, we get a bump on an engineer. I didn't see that engineer at all until he was already dead. Okay, I see a demo man shooting at something, but then I disintegrate. So I was like, okay, how did I die there? So let's take it back, and let's reflect on what happened and what I could have done better. Okay, what did I die to? Don't see any pyro around me. Oh, there it was. I died to that new sniper rifle, the one that does the laser death. So that was fair. So how could I have known that? If I look back again, was there anything I could have done to know that that sniper was there?
Mission ends in 60 seconds.
Did I see him? I could have seen his head over the top of that rock there. But again, we're only really seeing it because we're looking at the replay. He's not in my field of view there. Oh, did anyone see that? There was a sniper dot on the rock right in front of me, right before I died. So, no, I probably could not have avoided that death. It was just bad luck. Everything kind of worked out right so that the sniper could get that kill. But on the same map, I ended up having this life, so let's have a look at it.
Mission ends.
Okay, so the next life.
Mission ends in 10 seconds.
coming out of spawn. Trying to stop them from capping because it's almost over time. But I don't get to the payload, I don't slow it down, and the team wasn't able to stop it. Long cloak time with the Lutron J. Not as long as you used to get. There's that spy trying to get off the rocks again. It made that scout go back, and I got a free stab. Nobody saw the stab on the soldier. So I'm moving up on the cart. Just a stab on the medic. Got an air blast from the pyro. This spy could have had me. He jumped, but he didn't crouch. Here, I'm sorry I stopped that too much. Let's go back.
Mission ends in 60.
Okay, there we go. And you see, he did not jump. He didn't crouch as he jumped, otherwise he would have been able to get over the top of me. So my dead ringer had been active. I'm looking for health and ammo. I see the spy, try and position for his back. But you can see here, even though the ragdoll in replay is showing that he has a head, you can see the silhouette of the spy. He got away. And if we go to here, we might be able to see where he got away to. Okay, he did ring it away, and he got his health and ammo back fairly quickly. I'm calling out for spy. I don't know where that spy went. I am checking the backyard. Don't see him anywhere. So I give up on him. I saw that pyro was on low health, and I felt a little bit of a bump on that spy, so he must have got triggered again by that soldier and medic that had just come through there. So I missed that at the time of the gameplay. I did feel it, but I didn't have any idea where he went. No disguise again because I'm using a Your Eternal Reward. I'm gonna let that medic take care of the scout. I see the health packs missing here, so I don't know if something came through the backyard. I assume something did. A lot of people calling for spy, suddenly a pyro. And the pyro hears it and he chases down, but he gets distracted by a teammate. I'm hitting with the Lutron Day shot so that I can get some extra cloak. Trying to help my cloak back up and distract on the cart, and my teammates can move in. That was good. I say thank you to the demo man. Same situation with Taro as I'm coming around the corner. Two metal packs there, so my ring is ready practically straight away. Watching to see where those blues go before deciding to go this way. Health and ammo are missing here. Have to wait on it. So I assume something's come through this area recently. Oh, my knife raised. I'm so upset that I missed that. And then, wait, how in the world was that even a hit at all? Let's go back. Come on, Val. Okay, first of all, that. I'm upset at this. First, my knife is raising, so it was indicating a backstab. Then I got a shot when he clearly wasn't on my screen. Look at that. How does that count as any hit at all, Valve? So yeah, one of us was on a high ping there, and it sure as heck wasn't me.
We have been awarded additional time.
Alright, on my screen he was much more in my camera. Whoa, fortunate stab there on the sniper who was looking at being chased. So I've got a sniper disguise. Body blocking that scout. Pyro's distracted, so I leap stab. And I get chased by a scout, so we get him at a corner on the top. That was nice. Trying to pretend I'm pushing the payload so that my team can surprise whatever's coming. Well, didn't expect that spy. we do a little spy dance and neither of us get anything. Now let's check on the replay to see if he's actually dead. Let's see, blue spy. The only blue spy that's alive is this guy. So I'm pretty sure we got the other one dead. Yep. Yeah, there was the other spy. He didn't see any of that, so I can wait on his health. Poke meat is low, so I'm going to hang out here a bit. While we're hanging out here a bit, let's analyze the situation. What happened? Looks like our team is messing around with both the scout and the spy here. That battle happened very close.
I appreciate your time.
Ready to charge! Incoming! Incoming! Move these machines up!
Got that soldier right before he got the health. He was focused on getting that health. That demo man was going off with a spy, so I let them do it. Jumping over the Hualong Heater's flames. That spy is onto me, but he doesn't get it. Pyro was distracted. Saw a bit of smoke from that spy. I wasn't gonna fall for a trick stab there. The medic did pick him up. I checked his body at game time and he was dead.
Get to the bomb cart!
Replays are such good for reflection. You can really see what went on, and if something is in question, you can go and check it. I got air blasted then. The pyro thought I still backed off towards my team, but I came here instead. Far enough away that he might not have heard the ringer, but I end up getting further away anyway. Don't really want to go towards their spawn. End up coming back waiting on this health again. Heavy medic going up top. The heavy looked back. That heavy is a regular on the server, so I trusted that he might have seen me.
Stand next to the bomb!
I have no disguise, as the sentry gun showed. Oh, I was really wounded. Pull him back for this health pack. Let's see if I can get behind that heavy medic again. But they're backed off. And look at this. Okay, so I found a teleporter. I failed a stab on the spy. The pyro's just come through and the engineer knows I'm there. This is not where you want to be as a spy! This is worst situation. I get a sap on it, but then I back out. Let the team know I'm there. And wouldn't you know it.
Excellent! The couch moving back!
Wouldn't you know it, the team. Look at that. What a glorious team. They came on in and they totally wrecked what was there. Good job. So I didn't have to go back and worry about it. I actually triggered my own ringer there. I needed a bit more health, so I wanted to use the speed boost to get me up to this health and ammo. That had the large ammo pack anyway, so my ringer's already ready. Soldiers all alone coming up here. I tried to avoid his eyesight. Let's go back a little there. I tried to avoid his eyesight, but he still managed to see me just out of the corner of his vision. Just out of the corner. So watch. As he goes up, I realize that he's going for the health and ammo there, so he's going to turn around. So I duck off to the left here, so hopefully he won't be able to see me. But he saw a little bit of the edge. Managed to see it. Wouldn't have done that any different. Fortunate on that scout, he was just in a bad spot at the right time. Well. Caught the spy as he was going up. I dropped my ringer. He's been known to try trick stabbing. We don't get the counter stab, but scout was Johnny on the spot. Yeah, I'm gonna go back get more ammo. And I see a spy moving in on a gun that's way back here at Charlie. Well, demo man and I see stickies. So let's try and go around on it. Fail stab before a stab on the cart. I don't know if any... I think that soldier is much more distracted about the sentry gun than he is about a spy. But moving in on this demo nest here. I don't know if I killed the demo man with the stickies. No, I did not. Looks like my teammate died to the demo man who had the stickies. I was getting healed by the medic, so I don't know if any of these guys are going to believe in disguise. I'm going to hang out here a second. I announced the spy because I saw that the spy's head was missing on his ragdoll, so I know he ring it from that one. 10 seconds left, just watching the car. Again, Heavy looks back, but he goes back towards the overtime payload. And we're able to get the final kill. So yeah, self-reflection with the replays. I mean, do it. It is so advantageous to see what went on, what was funny. Maybe you got a highlight. Maybe it's something you want to upload yourself or send in. Thanks for watching. I hope this helps you in your future endeavors. This is a public service announcement about the Bombonomicon. Several people have told me that, Mr. Paladin, you should use a Bombonomicon with a dead ringer, because the Bombonomicon will explode, hiding your croissant body. But there's some problems with this. First of all, let's highlight the problem. That spies leave behind a crumpled spy body with no head, often known as the croissant spy.